So today I went back to see The Little Mermaid for a second time because I don't know, this film means a lot to me. And I actually saw a video that said that it hadn't received as high a ratings as what they were hoping, but I really like the film and I kind of want to watch it to see that, you know, if I was to be in it, how would I change things and like what would I do differently and stuff like this. You know, I feel like I'm a massive fan on the cartoon. I feel like that was perfect, except for the color of the fish. I would prefer an orange fish, not a yellow and blue. But everything else was really, really good. But with this one, I feel like there definitely was things wrong with it. And I wanted to watch it again, and my mum hadn't actually seen it, so I went with her. And just to see like what I thought was actually wrong with it. And the things I think were wrong were at the beginning, there in the cartoon, there's like this big sort of show and a big like a celebration almost of a show where people, lots and lots of people gather, and or lots of mer people gather, and they watch these Triton's daughters or whatever, and that is such a crucial part of the film. And not having it made me actually feel like the budget of this film was actually quite low, or deliberately lower than it should have been. Or I mean, there's so many films, and it just felt like a kind of standard production rather than like a high budget one or anything, because you know, that show at the beginning is really important. Why? Because it sets the scene. You know, Little Mermaid is not an idiot. She is not an idiot. And anyone who would be willing to risk their life to get a human to like them when they've never been human and never spoken or met that person, you know, I feel like you'd have to be quite a big idiot to do that. The only thing that would make you not an idiot is if you actually have tons of confidence in yourself and believe that, you know, you could easily get a guy to kiss you in 3 days. Only that amount of confidence would kind of give you will make you do something like that, unless, you know, if you're not stupid and you have confidence. But this show is supposed to kind of like big up Ariel. It's supposed to make Ariel seem like, you know, she's loved by her whole community. And you know, maybe even show a more of a background where she's talking to friends or something, and just not happy because she just generally wants something better. You know, I think the little Ariel character, you know, she obviously likes Eric for not just being a guy, but you know, she obviously likes the whole picture and the whole back package that comes with it. You know, not only is he a human, he's a prince and he's got a big castle. And you know, she obviously loves being a human rather than, you know, it's not just about the guy, it's about the whole ideal of being on the surface rather than underground and in underwater. And yeah, I feel like that scene, because they didn't have it and they just had like people, just his daughters sitting around, you didn't really build up a very big picture of what this underground world is like. So it felt quite a low budget. I thought Sebastian talked way too fast sometimes. You know, I love my child. Like he's sort of in, I can't do his accent. I can't do his accent at all. But in the original Disney, he speaks a lot slower with a lot more pronunciation. There's a lot more sort of hesitation in his words. And, you know, you really kind of want to know what he says next. Whereas I feel like in this one, the crab just, it just splat out too quick, too this, too fast, and it didn't draw as much like energy and passion behind it. And that fish looked really ugly as well. I didn't like the fish. It looked very ugly. I think the romance as well. I realized something, that the romance between him and the fish and mermaid just didn't work at all, because I kind of I couldn't figure out why it didn't work last time, and now I realize I do know why it works. Why? Because Ariel's with this guy for 3 whole days, and this guy does not kiss her. I mean, you'd have to be a pretty big prat. I mean, if you really like someone, to wait 3 days before kissing that person, I feel like you would have to be an absolute prat or prick to do that. Like, for example, I do massage, and I'm pretty sure that the majority of my clients would love me or love to kiss me during this 1 hour session. And okay, often I'm talking to them, but you know, if I didn't speak, all I need to do is go sit on a sofa for 10 minutes, and I'm pretty sure a lot of them would want to kiss me after 10 minutes. So yeah, to think that this girl and this guy have been together for 3 whole days and he's still not that interested in, that obviously shows that there wasn't actually a connection in the original, like the idea of the story. That obviously isn't actually that much of a connection between the Eric guy and the mermaid, and I think that's how it's supposed to be. Eric is supposed to be, I think he's put down in the film, because he's seen as a prince, but you actually see the king and queen who are black, and it doesn't really make sense because he's white, and so it doesn't even, it seems more like he's just like a foster child or something. Yeah, it should be that, you don't see the parents, you only see Eric. Eric's sort of bigged up. Eric's, he's in his fantasy world. He can, you could have him talking about, oh, I've seen mermaids and I really believe in mermaids, and I don't know, he could have like this fascination with mermaids, and not like, if I was the character, not like me, not because I'm, or any other reason, but just because he's actually seeking this mermaid, and I'm not a mermaid, a mermaid who can sing as well. So I feel like, that's, yeah, that could be the reason why. And I think I might change it if I was in it. I could have like me captured. I do like the boat idea, and then taken on shore. And perhaps on shore, I like meet this. Well, I would actually have the idea of them being captured and then thinking, okay, we've got a naked person on my boat, a naked woman on my boat who doesn't talk. Let's take her to the market. And on, when wait, I could, they can put some handcuffs on me, but I could be like, oh, a bracelet, like not understanding that this is actually me being sold off to as a slave or something. I think that's kind of a nice idea because it would show that I just have no clue about how, or that the character has no clue about how awful the world is. So you could take me, put it on the wristband, which is actually a handcuff, but and then on the beach, Eric could come and be like, I think I recognize you, and then be like, oh, you're not the mermaid. Maybe I have stuff around me, clothes or whatever. And then he realizes that I'm not the mermaid because I don't speak and I have legs. And then he sort of walks away. And then you could see, all the girls looking terrified as to what's about to happen next, and kind of me going up on stage being like all happy, hi, like having no clue why I'm actually on the stage. Just thinking this is like a normal, like maybe a human's welcoming me or something. And then the Eric character could look up and be like, why is she happy to be sold as, like, does she not know what's going on? And then he could like be like, all right, okay, I'll buy this and have it as like my scullery maid or something. And then during this, because then he's kind of like a prick because he's spending all this time trying to search for this mermaid. Only because of her voice, only because of the fact that she's a mermaid, and then the actual person who he's looking for is actually under his nose, but he doesn't really recognize her and doesn't really know who she is, and is kind of putting me in a scullery, because it doesn't make sense why you just meet a stranger. If you're a prince and if you're like, got a nice house and nice lifestyle, it doesn't make sense that you just meet some stranger off the beach and take them back to your house. But if it's a stranger that you've kind of just bought because you were saving her from the market, from some sort of slave market or whatever, then it does kind of make sense why I would be in the house in the first place. And it also would make sense why he wouldn't want to kiss me in the first day or two. And then maybe after 2 days, he starts realizing that actually maybe I am this one only. I don't know. I don't know how it worked, but and there's also something else they missed, which is that Ursula is supposed to like get some sort of vision of it getting too close. I'm sure I didn't really see that. Like Ursula didn't, there wasn't a it wasn't clear that Ursula needed to step in because, obviously this was trying to, it was going to happen, the kiss was going to happen, and she was going to lose out on the prize that she was getting, or wanting to get. So I don't know, I think that needed to be a little bit clearer, that she felt threatened. And also there was no like big wedding, the whole leaving off with him going off to celebrate the wedding on the Ursula's wedding. I don't know, I felt like it wasn't, I felt like it this wasn't very big. It was kind of like an under production. But yeah, I'm sure we could do a lot better than that. Is there anything else I wanted to say? And get brighter colors as well. and have a bit more of a proper wedding at the end.